And I'm Joe Beretta.
I missed Joe.
Oh, I missed you. Oh, look at these graphics. They're so cool.
What?
I missed you too. Look at these graphics.
Well, the 64th annual Emmys kicked off last night in Hollywood, California without a hitch. Beautiful people came out in hordes. Gowns cascaded down the aisle. Blue seemed to be a predominant theme.
And there were so many boobs.
Okay, Joe.
No, seriously, look at those boobs. Check out those boobs. And those boobs look like a butt.
Joe.
That is Sofia Vergara's butt. Her butt looks like boobs.
Okay.
You can't get any better than that.
No, you're right. There was genuinely a lot of boobs. But more than that, there was a community of stars, writers, directors, etc., all together in one joyous room. It was wonderfully hosted by the just delightful Jimmy Kimmel. Genuinely, just so delightful.
Yeah, I really like that guy. Like, he's like one of us. He's just a guy on TV making millions upon millions of dollars.
Yeah.
I think that guy's my favorite late night talk show host, and Craig Ferguson is a close second. Mm. The days of Letterman and Leno are over.
Over. And of course, there was a few surprises, like Homeland beating out Breaking Bad, Mad Men, Boardwalk Empire, Downton Abbey, and Game of Thrones for Best Drama Series. And it's the first drama series that's won an Emmy on Showtime, including Weeds and Dexter.
That's crazy. And it also won Best Actress and Actor in a Drama Series with Claire Danes and Damian Lewis. Other shows that came out on top, it was a little deja vu with Modern Family winning Best Comedy Series, Best Supporting Actor, Actress, and Directing in a Comedy Series, even though, you know, Big Bang is the highest rated comedy television show out there right now, and I think it has been for a while, so some people are like, what? And other people are like, cool. A lot of people just don't care.
Yeah. Some other highlights for me personally were when Jon Stewart got up to receive his award for Best Variety Series and Stephen Colbert and Jimmy Fallon decided to tackle him down the aisle the entire way.
That was so good.
Also, Louis C.K. winning just about anything makes my heart happy, but it's more than that for me. This guy is revolutionizing comedy in television as we know it. He's the star, the writer, director, and editor of the series, and it's friggin' awesome.
And I want to be that dude or hang out with that dude. Maybe that dude and his kids and my kids, we can have a play date. We can have a play date, and then we can sit on the park bench and laugh at them and make fun of them. For being young with small brains. And what's cool about Louis C.K. winning is that he's thankful, but he honestly seems like he didn't expect it. And I love that. And another thing I loved was Aaron Paul winning again for his badass portrayal of Jesse Pinkman in Breaking Bad. That dude just seems like crazy, genuine, and happy to be in the industry. He's just like, I'm here. Oh man, this is great. And when he says thank you, I actually believe it. And that's the thing. The reason we're saying Jon Stewart and Louis C.K. and Aaron Paul are our favorite moments, it's because these people seem genuine. It's like they haven't subscribed to the Hollywood bullshit and they're just still normal people having fun, play and pretend for all of us.
Hey Joe, I don't know if you know this, but I totally had a moment with Aaron Paul this year at Comic-Con.
You mean when you grabbed his arm and you said like, oh, I love you, and then he said it back, but like in a really scared voice?
Yep.
I really don't think that qualifies as a moment.
Okay, you don't tell me who I love. And for the winners in all the categories, click on the link in the description down below. And all in all, it was a really great night of winners and losers. You know, the kind of losers that still get to be nominated for an Emmy and make television for a living while rolling in money and fame.
Sucks for them. Question, so what did you guys think of the Emmys last night? And what is your favorite show on television right now? Let us know in the comments down below.
And of course, click on that like and subscribe button if you haven't already. Click on this beautiful annotation or go to sourcefed.com to see the 5 stories of the day, every other story we've ever done. I'm Lee Newton.
I'm Joe Beretta.
I'm not kidding, we had a connection.
I love you too!
No, it wasn't that scared. It was literally like, we met, our eyes locked. I was like, I love you. He was like, I love you too. And I know it sounds like a question, but in my heart, I knew it was a real answer.